What's up, guys? So last video we talked about CSS and we did an internal style sheet. So we're going to play around a little bit more with that, and then we're going to look at how to create an external CSS sheet. So let's get into the code that we were playing with. And I created a second one and added a few more features for us. So what I did here, starting from the top, is I added a comment. So right here it says last updated, and I put the date and updated by. Change that to a colon. And a comment means only those in the HTML document can see it, so it's helpful if you're working in a larger organization where multiple people could be touching the code. This is a way to keep track of who's doing what and when. I also added a few additional meta tags. So I added a name with a description, content hello world, intro to HTML. I added a meta tag for the author, that's me, and then a meta tag for the viewport, which says that the site will fit the width of the device. So if they're looking at this at a smaller computer, it's going to fit the smaller computer, or a mobile phone, it's going to fit the mobile phone, so that they don't have to scroll left or right, because that's very awkward. Now I added one more CSS feature here, the background color. Remember, we had the background color in, then we just turned it to color for the text. And then I added it back, and this time I picked a different color. You'll see what that color looks like. It's kind of a light blue. And then in order for us to see the effects a little bit better, I added a little bit more text to this paragraph here so that it's two sentences instead of one. It says, "Welcome to my awesome website. It is here that we will see a transformation using the power of HTML and CSS." Fun times. I added a few more paragraphs here with the and in BSP semicolon. That is a special character that represents a space. It'd be like you hitting the space bar. Remember, HTML is white space insensitive, which means that I can sit here and hit space all I want. It's not going to notice it in the website itself unless I'm typing and in BSP space, and in BSP space, because each one of these characters represents a single space in HTML. I threw a few div tags in there, which by themselves literally mean nothing to the browser, but when we start adding some features to them, then you'll see them come to life. So I have the paragraph here, the top part of the website in a div, and then the footer in a div. And then one more special character here, ampersand copy semicolon, which is the little copyright symbol with the C. If we run this now, and I'm going to click yes, this is that background I was telling you about. So see, it's a light blue across the line here. And then there's the copyright symbol, copyright by Melody Chronister. Otherwise, it looks pretty much the same as we left it, so a little dull and boring. So the first thing I think we should do is change the font. And again, I'm not going to spend a bunch of time on this because we'll have a whole video just for fonts. So up in our style tags here, right in front of the first style tag, let's just hit enter. And then I'm going to type the word body. So I'm telling it to style everything in the body with these specific declarations. I'm going to hit enter. And then I'm going to do font hyphen family colon. And if you notice, Daptana was trying to do it for me, but I'm going to type it myself. And then I'm going to do Tahoma first, and then just in case they're using a computer that doesn't have Tahoma on the computer, I'm going to type in the word monospace, which is the family it belongs to. Again, a whole video will talk about that. So for now, just type it as you see it, and let's see what happens. So I typed in font family, Tahoma, comma, make sure there's a space right there, and then monospace, semicolon, and let's give it a shot. Let's run this puppy. And look, doesn't that look much better already? It says, "Hello world, welcome to my awesome website," all with the Tahoma font. Awesome. Okay, now the next thing I wanted to do is center that text. It's really tough. I know even just recording this video, I have to zoom out in order for you to see the whole thing. So for design purposes, I want to go ahead and center the whole thing. So to do that, I can just go up here in this body tag again, since this applies to the whole site. And I'm going to do text align colon space center semicolon. And yes, it's down here too, which at this point doesn't really matter because this is going to override this one. But let's go ahead and run it. And there, now it's all centered. Very cool. Okay, now let's say instead of the blue bar, I want the background of the whole site to be that light blue. I just like that color, right? This time, instead of retyping it, I'm just going to cut this one out and paste it up here within our body declaration. And then let's run it again. And there, now we have the light blue. So we're making a lot of good progress here, but now let's say I want to style just a specific area. Let's play around with these divs that right now have no meaning. This first div, I'm going to assign it an ID. Now, an ID in CSS, so I'm going to type in here, let's call it div 1. Okay, so an ID in CSS can only be assigned to one item in your web page. That's the difference between an ID and a class. A class can be assigned to multiple locations. So this class test here, I literally can copy and paste this on any other tag and apply the same styles to that classification. But with an ID, only one tag in my HTML document can have this ID name. So that's the difference between the two. And to be honest with you, most developers just tend to stay away from the ID. They use just the word class, because you never know, down the road you may add something to your site and think, oh, I want to apply this same styles up as up here. But that means it'd have to be a class and not an ID. So when in doubt, use the word class, because even if you end up only assigning it to one, it gives you the option down the road to assign it to multiple if you'd like. Okay, enough of that. So let's go back up here in our embedded style sheet and let's add the selector for an ID. Now, remember with the classes we used a period, with IDs we use a hashtag or a pound sign, and then we type in the name of it. So I called it div1, and then let's add our opening bracket. Remember, it's the curly ones. And let's see, with this div, what do I want to do to it that's different? Let's change the background. That will probably look pretty cool. So background, color, and this time let's do white. I'm not even going to use a hex code. I'm just going to use a plain old color. And then let's run this and see what it looks like. Pretty neat, right? So in the center here, it has the background is white. And remember, I added two additional paragraph tags with empty spaces, that special character. So that's why we see this blank space here below. So if I wanted to, I can even grab these blank paragraphs. I'm going to copy them. Let's say I put it above. So I have some empty space above and below. Let's run that again. There, that really makes it stand out now, right? So we have this in the center that's white, then the rest of the background in the site is that pretty light blue that we chose. Now, final part in this video, let's go ahead and do an external style sheet. Now, what's helpful with external such style sheets is that we can take that style sheet and assign it to any HTML document that we want, which is helpful because most web pages have several, we're talking hundreds potentially, of pages. The Imperial College website has thousands of pages to it. So you wouldn't want to manually build these styles on each page. Oh Lord, that would take forever. So what you do is you create an external style sheet, and then on each document you just simply put a line of code that links it to that style sheet. That way if you decide to change it up, change some colors, fonts, whatever, all you're changing is that one document that everything is linked to, and it will automatically apply that style to all the pages it was linked to. So very helpful. So when we are creating an external style sheet, we just grab the style bracket, the opening and closing, and we're going to cut this out. Oh no, where'd it go? It's okay. I'm gonna go ahead and save this. And then now let's create a new CSS file. So I'm going to go to File, New, File, and then we're going to call it styles.css, and then we're going to put it in the same folder as our website, very important, and then click Finish. Now we have it open, and we see here it's right with my index2.html. That's what I wanted to see, and I don't need this language that it already gave me because I have my own, so I deleted that, and I'm going to paste what we cut from the HTML. Now with the CSS, since it's saved as .css, we don't need to tell it it's CSS. It's in the file extension. So we just delete this opening and closing style bracket. And this may seem weird, but this is all we need. Style sheets only consist of the selectors and the declarations. And that's it. It may seem short for now, but believe me, when we start adding in styles to our navigation bars and all that extra stuff, this document will get plenty full. So don't you worry about that. And then let's go ahead and just go File, Save. Now the last part is, of course, even though this is saved and it's in the same folder, we still need to tell our HTML document to look at this style sheet. So up in our head, so I'm going to hit Enter, I'm above the closing head bracket, we are going to do a link element tag. So that's link space REL for relationship equal sign and then the quotation and then it's going to be style sheet. So I'm just going to double click on that. Another space, we just told it to look at a style sheet because we'll use this link relational even for JavaScript down the road, but this time we're doing a style sheet and then space, and this is where we tell it where it's at. href and then equal sign and then it's styles.css. And that's it. Don't forget to put the file name in quotes so it should look identical to this. And our hyperlink reference, our href, is stylesheets.css. If our styles.css was saved in a different folder, then it might be longer. Let's say I had it saved in the test folder, then that would be test/styles. But since it's saved in the root next door to the index page that it's referencing, then it's perfect just as is. And now we can go ahead and run it. So we're going to click the green arrow to run. Hit yes. So you may think, well, what happened? Nothing happened. That's the point. If we would have just taken the style sheet out, so yeah, let's do that. Let's go ahead and grab this just to show you the difference. I'm going to cut this line out, and then I'm going to run this. Oh, boring again. Now let's put it back. Paste. Run it again. Oh, colors are back. So see, just that one line of code is all that is in our HTML document. And that one line of code is telling it to look at the style sheet. And the style sheet is where we are housing all of the styles we want for our web page. So I hope you found this video helpful. Next, we start talking about the CSS box model and positioning, which is how we lay out our website the way we want. And then we're going to talk about fonts. So much exciting things ahead. I hope you are enjoying these videos, and I will see you in the next one.